Hey guys, welcome to my coffee talk / weekly Z-Gym motivation video. I hope that you're ready to take action this week and work out with me every single day. Some people say that knowledge is power, and it definitely helps to know what exactly you should be doing in order to lose weight or build muscles or whatever your goal might be. It definitely helps to know what kind of exercises you should be doing, what foods you should be eating. But even if you have all this knowledge, what is knowledge without taking an action? The action is what's important, so I really want to encourage you this week to take action every single day, come to Z-Gym, work out with me daily. This week I have for you 3 brand new workouts. One of them is gonna be 8-minute Tabata workout. I have designed this workout series thanks to my Z-Gym member Tanya, who asked for workouts that would be really short but really intense, so that she can wake up in the morning and do this workout right away and then go to work. She doesn't have the time in the morning to do a long workout, and she doesn't really want to wake up an hour earlier because that might be uncomfortable. So for those of you who don't have that much time in the morning but you still want to fit one workout in and really feel the energy from the workout and really feel like you boosted your metabolism and that you did something really good for your body, these 8-minute Tabata workouts are gonna be amazing. So just imagine this scenario. Your alarm goes off in the morning, you jump out of the bed, and really jump out of the bed. Try not to dilly-dally in the bed too much. Really try to, as soon as you hear the alarm, as soon as you're awake, get up, start moving. Set up your exercise mat and your exercise equipment so that you can start working out right away. You're gonna start with 3-minute warm-up that I have in the Z-Gym. Then you're gonna do the 8-minute Tabata workout. That's 11 minutes. Then you're gonna add 5-minute cool down and stretching, not longer than that. That's 16 minutes in the morning. You can be done in 16 minutes, then have your breakfast and go to work. Now, some of you might be asking whether you should work out on an empty stomach or what should you drink or eat before your workout. It's totally fine to work out on your empty stomach. However, I do suggest that you hydrate yourself. Normally, I would drink a cup of coffee and then I would have some water and then I would do a workout. But it's on the day when I have just more time in the morning and I can dilly-dally a little bit and have enough time to hydrate myself. I don't suggest drinking coffee in the morning when you just don't have too much time, when you're in a rush, because coffee will dehydrate you, and that's not good to be dehydrated during the workout. So before a workout, if you're really going for time and you're really pressed on time, I suggest that you hydrate yourself with coconut water. This is the coconut water that I drink. It's 100% coconut water, no sugar added. This is not a sponsorship. I'm just letting you know what I really drink when I really need to get something into my system, fill up on electrolytes, and get my body hydrated. So 1 glass of coconut water before the workout, it's gonna give you the electrolytes, the natural sugars, and the energy to work out. It's gonna keep you hydrated. And after the workout, you can have your breakfast and enjoy your day. Now, if you're somebody who's been wanting to make this big change in your lifestyle and start exercising every single day or start exercising every single morning, but you're just wondering how to do it because it seems really hard, and you're wondering how other people do it. There are a lot of people who do that every single day. It's actually really simple. The difference between the people who do exercise on a daily basis and the people who don't is that the people that do, they look at exercise as their must. It's something that is on top of their priority list and they must exercise. Now, how do you make exercising on a daily basis as your must? The best way to do that is to realize how important it actually is and how much it's gonna affect you. First of all, the way you move your body, even a slight body language, does affect your mood, your state of mind, greatly. And you can try it right now. If you're sitting down, try to slouch, try to roll your shoulders forward, put your head down, just completely slouch. How does it make you feel? Do you feel like you have a lot of energy? Now try to bring your chest up. Really push your shoulders back and down, chin up, and try to move a little bit. How does that make you feel? Do you feel more energy? I bet you do. So if this slight change in your body language affects your mood, how much do you think daily exercise will affect the state of your mind? If your morning routine starts with a workout that will boost your energy, your metabolism, and raise up your endorphin levels, your state of mind is going to be completely different than if you didn't do anything in the morning and just had your breakfast and head out to work. You're going to be in a completely different state of mind, and you're going to be most likely making better decisions throughout the day, because state of mind matters. If you're in a good state of mind, you're going to be making good decisions. Lousy state of mind, lousy decisions. And if you start your day by raising your endorphin levels and putting yourself in good mood, the chances are that you're gonna be focusing for the entire day on more positive thoughts, and that's really important. It's important that we don't torture ourselves constantly with negative thoughts, negative thinking, and negative emotions. Not that it's not gonna happen, but it's good to always be able to switch the focus. And when you start your day with a lot of energy on the right now, you're gonna be able to switch your focus like that. Now guys, I wanna give you a heads up, because next week we're gonna start a brand new workout series in the Z Gym. It's called Jump Rope Cardio and Abs, and this series will focus on high intensity cardio workout with jump rope, and also we're gonna be doing the best ab exercises. So we're gonna be combining these two powerful training methods together so that you can burn tons of calories and really target your core muscles. And the reason why I'm giving you a heads up about this upcoming series today is because I want you to be ready for it. And especially those of you who cannot use the jump rope at home because maybe you have low ceilings, or maybe because you're not there with your skills yet and you keep tripping over the rope and you keep getting frustrated during my jump rope workouts. I don't want you to be frustrated, I want you to be ready. And because I want you to get all the benefits of the jump rope workouts, this is what I suggest you to get. This is a ropeless jump rope. This is what it looks like. I'm gonna have a link for you on my website and underneath this video so you can check it out. I got this on Amazon. I buy almost all of my equipment on Amazon.com. It's incredible, they have everything. I'm gonna demonstrate right now that you can do all of the exercises that I do with the jump rope with this, even if you're a complete beginner. High knees, twist jump, jumping jacks, rockets, double unders, so as you can see, you can do a lot with the ropeless jump rope, and you can get a great cardio in even if you're a complete beginner. So I really do suggest that you guys look it up online and find it in your area. Maybe they sell it in a nearby store, or maybe you can get it online. So guys, that's it for today. Have a great week. Stay consistent. Work out with me daily in the Z Gym, and I will see you guys tomorrow with another workout. Ciao.